With an average career length of 3.3 years, some NFL players last for over a decade in the league, while others shine brightly for a short time and then fizzle out soon after. Here are 10 players who lit up the league, but soon faded away as some of the NFL's greatest one-year wonders of all time. Peyton Hillis, 2010. The Denver Broncos intended to play Hillis, a 7th-round pick, at fullback, but injuries gave him a starting opportunity at running back. Hillis ran for an impressive 5 yards per carry as a rookie before a hamstring tear ended his season. However, a coaching change in Denver led to just 17 touches in 2009, and Hillis was traded to the Browns for quarterback Brady Quinn. When starter Jerome Harrison suffered an injury, it became Hillis's time to shine. In his Browns starting debut, Hillis ran for 144 yards against a strong Ravens defense and followed it up with another 100-yard effort the next week against the Bengals. Hillis maintained course over the rest of the season, finishing with 1,177 yards and 11 touchdowns on the ground and 61 catches for 447 yards. Hillis's sudden explosion quickly made him a fan favorite when EA Sports put the cover star of Madden 12 up to a fan vote. The stars aligned for Hillis. He beat out Matt Ryan and Aaron Rodgers before defeating Michael Vick to become the most improbable Madden cover star of all time. Unfortunately for Hillis, his peak didn't last long. Contract disputes with the Browns and sitting out of a game with strep throat cost him favor with his teammates, and another hamstring injury kept him off the field. Hillis played in just 10 games in 2011, and his average rushing yards dropped to 0.8 yards a carry. The Browns declined to re-sign Hillis, and he moved to Kansas City, where an ankle sprain limited him to just 300 yards. He then spent 2 seasons with the Giants, and both seasons ended with concussions as Hillis fell out of the league, never quite reaching the highs of his 2010 season again. Greg Cook, 1969. A talented quarterback at the University of Cincinnati, Bengals owner Paul Brown saw enough playmaking ability from Cook to select him 5th overall in the 1969 draft. Cook immediately stepped into a starting role and led the Bengals to a 3-0 record, but injured his throwing shoulder in the 3rd victory. After sitting out for 3 weeks, Cook returned to his starting role despite dealing with the effects of an undiagnosed torn rotator cuff. Nonetheless, he led the league in yards per completion and was named AFL Rookie of the Year. Off-season surgery revealed that Cook's bicep had become detached, and 3 follow-up operations kept Cook away from the sport for almost 3 years. He briefly attempted a comeback in 1973, completing just 1 pass for 11 yards as a sad reminder of what could have been. According to former Bengals coach Bill Walsh, if not for the injuries, Cook could have very well been remembered or noted as the greatest quarterback of all time. Robert Griffin III, 2012. After being selected at number 2 overall in the NFL draft, Robert Griffin III's entrance into the league immediately signaled trouble for defenses. Griffin was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week after his NFL debut as part of a successful rookie season. He finished the year with 3,200 passing yards, 20 touchdowns, and 5 interceptions, along with 815 rushing yards and 7 rushing scores as he won Offensive Rookie of the Year honors. However, during a Week 14 clash against the Ravens, Griffin suffered an LCL sprain. In the Redskins' wildcard game against Seattle 4 weeks later, Griffin's knee gave out and he suffered a torn LCL and ACL. Coming off the injury, Griffin was healthy enough to start the 2013 season opener, but his completion percentage fell, interceptions rose, and the knee injury limited his effectiveness as a runner. He began the 2014 season as the team's starter once again, but a dislocated ankle in Week 2 kept him out until later in the year. Griffin struggled when he did see the field, throwing 4 touchdowns and 6 interceptions in 9 games. In the final season of his rookie deal in 2015, Griffin failed to see the field after suffering a concussion during the preseason, and his time in Washington soon came to an end. Griffin signed with the Browns in 2016, but an early season shoulder injury once again put his season on hold. He eventually signed with the Baltimore Ravens, where he remains as a backup quarterback, having thrown just 44 passes in the last 3 seasons combined. Larry Brown, 1995. a 12th round pick in the 1991 NFL draft. Expectations were fairly low for Brown, but he managed to carve out a spot as a depth cornerback for the Dallas Cowboys and totaled 7 interceptions in his first 4 seasons with the team. When the Cowboys added Hall of Famer Deion Sanders to their secondary in 1995, the move propelled Brown to the best year of his career. He intercepted 6 passes during the regular season and also made an interception in the NFC Championship game before his career-defining moment came in Super Bowl 30. Brown recorded 2 interceptions as the Cowboys won their 3rd Super Bowl in 4 seasons, and he was named Super Bowl MVP for his performance. Following the career year, Brown landed a big-money $12.5 million contract from the Oakland Raiders at the age of 26. However, after missing just 1 game in 5 seasons with the Cowboys, he played 12 of 32 games in 2 seasons with the Raiders, recording 1 interception. Failing to live up to his massive deal, the Raiders soon waived Brown, who returned to Dallas in 1998, played just 4 games in his final season of professional football. Icky Woods, 1988. After leading the NCAA with 1,658 rushing yards in 1987, Woods was a hot prospect in the 1988 NFL Draft, where he was selected number 31st overall by the Cincinnati Bengals. Woods immediately burst onto the scene as one of the league's top running backs, with a league-high 5.3 yards per carry as a rookie. Woods topped 1,000 yards, and his 15 touchdowns gave him plenty of opportunities to show off his signature Icky Shuffle celebration. The Bengals made it all the way to Super Bowl XXIII that season, but lost 20-16 to the San Francisco 49ers, despite 79 rushing yards from Woods. It seemed as though Woods might have a long and successful career ahead of him, but a torn ACL limited him to just 2 games in 1989. Following the injury, Woods' average rush fell from 5 yards to about 3.5 yards per carry as he struggled to reclaim his starting role. An injury to his right knee during the 1991 preseason further limited him to 36 carries, and with his effectiveness fading, Woods retired after the season. Tim Tebow, 2011. One of the most famous college football players of all time, Tebow was unstoppable as he won both a national championship and a Heisman Trophy at Florida. However, despite concerns about how his ability would translate to the next level, the Denver Broncos made him their first-round pick in 2010. Tebow spent his rookie season as a backup, a trend which continued in 2011 behind Kyle Orton. After a 1-3 start to the season, Tebow took over as the Broncos' starter. His numbers were fairly pedestrian, with a completion percentage below 50% and a whopping 14 fumbles. But the Tebow-led Broncos won games. After going 7-4 as a starter, he propelled the Broncos to a dramatic walk-off touchdown against the Steelers in the wildcard round. A 45-10 loss to the Patriots the next week ended the Broncos' season, and also Tebow's time with the team. Peyton Manning joined the organization in the offseason, and Tebow was shipped off to the New York Jets, where he threw 8 passes and ran 32 times in 2012, his final year in the league. Tebow has since spent the last 4 seasons a minor league baseball player in the New York Mets organization. In 2019, he hit just a .163 at the AAA level, but did participate in the Mets' spring training this year. Steve Berline, 1999. Unlike many of the players on this list who flamed out on their first contract, Berline had a long 14-year career in the NFL. Berline started 15 games in his first 2 seasons with the Los Angeles Raiders, until a contract dispute led to the Raiders keeping the perfectly healthy Berline inactive for every game of the 1990 season, before he was traded to Dallas. After playing well in limited action with the Cowboys, Berline signed a contract with the Cardinals. The 1993 season offered him his best starting opportunity, and Berline threw for 3,000 yards. However, when Buddy Ryan became Arizona's coach in 1994, that marked the end of Berline's time in the desert. He moved to Jacksonville, where he spent 1 mediocre season before joining the Carolina Panthers. There, he started sparringly behind Kerry Collins before taking over as the team's starter in 1998. As a career journeyman with a losing record and only one season as a full starter, Berline took the league by storm in 1999. He threw for a league-high 4,436 yards, along with 36 touchdowns, as the 34-year-old Berline made his first Pro Bowl. The 2000 season was a steep drop-off, as Berline threw 19 touchdowns and 18 interceptions. He ended up spending two more seasons with the Denver Broncos before retiring in 2003. Michael Clayton, 2004. Clayton entered the NFL as an exciting wide receiver prospect hailing from LSU, where Clayton had won a national championship and set a record for receiving touchdowns. That success prompted the Tampa Bay Buccaneers to select Clayton number 15 overall in the 2004 NFL Draft, and the wideout put together a stellar rookie season. Clayton caught 80 passes for 1,193 yards and 7 touchdowns as the Buccaneers' leading receiver. Offseason knee surgery put a damper on his 2005 campaign, and Clayton never quite found his groove, even as the Buccaneers made the playoffs. He spent four more seasons in Tampa Bay, putting together a few 30-catch and 300-yard seasons. Clayton moved on to New York, where he caught two passes in two seasons with the New York Giants, as his career ended in 2011. Although Clayton spent 8 years in the NFL, nearly 40% of his career catches and yardage came during his rookie season. Derek Anderson, 2007. Despite being drafted by the Ravens, Anderson never played for Baltimore. Instead, his career peak came for the divisional rival Cleveland Browns, who kept Anderson on their roster for the 2005 season, although he didn't appear in a game. He became the Browns' backup in 2006 and started three games before becoming the starter in 2007. Anderson balled out, throwing for 3,787 yards, 29 touchdowns, and 19 interceptions, and also made the Pro Bowl. Although he re-signed with the Browns in the offseason, Anderson faced competition from Brady Quinn, and injuries kept the more experienced Anderson from keeping his starting role in the 08 and 09 seasons, as he and Quinn traded opportunities. Anderson spent nine more seasons in the NFL as a backup for Arizona, Carolina, and Buffalo, compiling a 4-11 record as a starter with those teams before retiring in 2019. Rex Grossman, 2006. Following a successful college career at Florida, Grossman was the Chicago Bears' first-round selection in the 2003 NFL Draft, although he sparsely saw the field early in his career. Grossman started just 7 games in his first 3 seasons, as he suffered ligament damage and a broken ankle kept him out until late in the 2005 season, where he led the Bears to the playoffs. It was during the 2006 season that Grossman's gun-slinging, risk-taking playstyle was fully on display. Grossman piloted the Bears to a 13-3 regular season, as he threw for 3,200 yards and 23 touchdowns, even if he did have 20 interceptions and 8 fumbles. While Grossman did lead the Bears all the way to Super Bowl 41, his turnover troubles showed there, as he threw a pair of interceptions and fumbled twice in the loss. Grossman played poorly in 2007, going 2-5 as Chicago's starter, while throwing more interceptions than touchdowns. He spent one more season in Chicago as a backup before moving on to Houston, then Washington. Grossman went 5-8 as the Redskins' starter in 2011, tossing 20 interceptions compared to 16 touchdowns, and he never saw the field again. So, there you have it, the greatest NFL one-year wonders. Did we leave anybody off of this list? Let us know in the comments down below. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and drop a like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. As always, you're watching Nonstop Sports. We'll catch you next time.